Let us go for a problem on behalf of Clausius-Clebrand equation. Here we are having a problem. See, dichlorodichloromethane, that is CF2Cl2, is having a vapor pressure of 400 mmHg. At -81.6 degree centigrade, and -40 mmHg at -81.6 degree centigrade, and 400 mmHg at -43.9 degree centigrade, then you are asked to calculate the boiling point of dichlorodichloromethane. Yes, there is a compound that is dichlorodichloromethane, which is used as a refrigerant, and it destroys the ozone layer present in the atmosphere. Such particular gaseous substance, such particular liquid substance is having its corresponding vapor pressure at -81.6 degree centigrade as 40 mmHg, and this is -43.9 degree centigrade, that is higher temperature. With increasing of temperature, vapor pressure increases. The vapor pressure is found to be 400 mmHg. Now you are asked to calculate the vapor pressure of the dichlorodichloromethane substance. Yes, to solve this problem, here the temperature present in degree centigrade has to be converted to Kelvin scale, whereas temperature of degree centigrade plus 273 becomes equal to Kelvin temperature. Here one of the temperature is lower temperature, that is -81.6 degree centigrade, plus 273 will becomes equal to 191.4 Kelvin. Similarly, 43.9 degree centigrade minus 43.9 plus 273 will becomes equal to 229.1 Kelvin. These are the temperatures in Kelvin scale, and corresponding vapor pressures, if I write, the corresponding vapor pressures are at -81.6 degree centigrade, this will be 40 mmHg, and this will be 400 mmHg. Whereas these are the vapor pressures, and you were requested to find, you were asked to find the boiling point of the liquid. Boiling point is that one at which the vapor pressure of the system will become equal to what? Atmospheric pressure. Atmospheric pressure is 1 atmosphere. That 1 atmosphere, if I express in terms of centimeters, it becomes equal to 76 centimeters, and which will also become equal to what? 760 mmHg. By using Clausius-Clebrand equation, we have the relation that is log P2, vapor pressure under condition number 2, and vapor pressure under condition number 1 will becomes equal to delta H of vaporization divided by 2.303 into R of T2 minus T1 by T1 T2, otherwise T2 T1. This is the equation. This equation is said to be Clausius-Clebrand equation. Here P1 P2 stands for vapor pressures under second condition, vapor pressure under first condition. P1 T2 stands for temperature under first and second conditions. Delta HV, latent heat of vaporization, whereas R value depends on the values taken for delta H of vaporization. Suppose if we are taking in calories, R will becomes 2. If I am taking in joules, it will becomes equal to 8.314 joules. Now if I substitute these of all things, then I will know the delta H of vaporization. From the known value of delta H of vaporization, by considering one of the pressure and corresponding temperature as it is, and other one by considering it as 760 mm, then I can calculate the temperature, and that temperature is known as what? Boiling point temperature. On solving the things, on solving, log P2 by P1, that is log 400 by 40 will becomes equal to delta H of vaporization, that we have to calculate, that divided by 2.303 into, here I am taking R as 2 implies what? This is present in calories, into of T2 minus T1, T2 is higher temperature, that is 229 Kelvin minus 191 Kelvin divided by T1, T2. On solving these things, I came to know that the delta H of vaporization value is 5357.35 calories. Now I know the delta H of vaporization. Now I want to calculate the boiling point. What is boiling point? I want to know. Boiling point is that one at this particular temperature, vapor pressure of system will become equal to what? 1 atmospheric pressure. 1 atmospheric pressure implies how many in terms of centimeters and in terms of millimeters? It becomes equal to 760 mmHg. So therefore, on substituting these of all things, log 760 mmHg divided by, if I go for the second case, that is 400 mmHg, that will becomes equal to delta H of vaporization, that will becomes equal to 5357.35 calories divided by 2.303 into R value as 2 of here the boiling point temperature TB, that is T2 minus T1, 400 degree centigrade related, 400 atmosphere pressure related temperature is 229.1 minus divided by T2 times of 229.1. On solving this particular thing, it is found that on solving the things by considering the pressure at boiling point 760 mmHg, log P2 by P1 is equal to delta H by 2.303 times of R of T2 minus T1 by T1 T2. T2 is the boiling point temperature. The T2 minus T1 is 229.1 Kelvin divided by T2 into T1 will becomes equal to this particular term. After making towards this side by applying logarithms and all the values, it was found to be T2 minus 229.1 divided by T2 will becomes equal to 0.055, whereas here T2 by T2 will becomes equal to 1 minus 0.0555 will becomes equal to 0.945, that will becomes equal to 229.1 divided by T2, and T2 value is found to be equal to what? 242.43 Kelvin. And if I represent that one in terms of degree centigrade, minus 273, after making this will becomes equal to minus 30.57 degree centigrade. Thus the substance which is provided for us is having boiling point of minus 30.57 degree centigrade. Thus, with the help of Clausius-Clapeyron equation, you may ask it to calculate vapor pressure under other condition, or by providing all things, vapor pressure can be asked, or by providing all the things, the other temperature can be asked. You can be asked sometime to calculate the boiling point, and you can be asked to calculate the delta H of vaporization. Thus, these many things are interrelated with the Clausius-Clapeyron equation, that is vapor pressure under different conditions and different temperature conditions and the latent heat of vaporization of the substance. See, here already we made the discussion related to vapor pressure. We came to know that vaporization is a surface process and vaporization is a continuous process. After making the system in the sealed conditions, it always makes equilibrium under vaporization with respect to the condensation. After some time, it go for the static situation, that rate of vaporization will become equal to rate of condensation. Under that particular situation and its onwards, the pressure exerted by the vapor over the liquid surface is constant, and that particular pressure is known as what? Vapor pressure. Whereas here the case that now we are going to discuss is vapor pressure of solid presenting liquid as a solution. So there is a solution. In the beginning there is a solvent. We know how to measure the vapor pressure of solvent and how vapor pressure is present. Now that solvent is added with some solid material and it is forming a homogeneous mixture. After formation of homogeneous mixture, how vapor pressure is present and how it is related with the original vapor pressure of the solvent, let us have a discussion. See, here I am taking some solid material. This solid material is added to liquid. This liquid is major component. This major component is known as solvent, whereas our solid is minor component, and this is known as what? Solute. And they mix with one another, as a result it forms a homogeneous mixture, and this homogeneous mixture is known as what? Solution. Up to here we are very clear. Whereas here that solution, suppose see here I am representing the solution in a vessel, this is the solution. Whereas in this solution there are many layers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like this solution is present and this is the solution. In the beginning it is a solvent, so therefore whenever it is solvent under sealed conditions, let us consider that here some of the molecules present in the solvent from its upper surface are entered into the vapor state. Let us consider from this molecule onwards, one molecule is entered into the vapor state. From here onwards, one molecule entered into the vapor state. One molecule is entered into the vapor state. One molecule is entered into the vapor state. So this is the situation of the solvent. Before adding the solute into the solvent, this is a pure solvent. Pure solvent is having vapor pressure, and that is said to be the vapor pressure of the pure solvent. Vaporization is a surface process. It is a complete 100% pure material. From its upper surface, molecules whichever are having higher kinetic energy, that is most probable velocity associated molecules, are entered into the vapor state and they reach to the static situation, that is rate of vaporization is equal to rate of condensation situation is attained. Under that conditions, it offers some weight over the surface, and that weight is restricted to unit area, and that particular force which is acting for unit area is known as its pressure, and this is the situation related to the pure solvent. Now after making this one as the solution, suppose it is made as solution, yes, the same system, now it is appearing in the form of solution after addition of what? Some solid material. Now let us see, it is forming a homogeneous mixture, as I said, that is a solution. See, in this homogeneous mixture, this particle is of solute particle, this particle is of solute particle. Assume that this particle is of solute particle because I am taking every layer as the reference. In every one layer, here as per the calculation is concerned, out of 5 molecules, one molecule is of solute molecule, one molecule is of solute molecule. Like this, solute is present. Everywhere, in every one layer, if I take as the reference, here whatever the concentration, 4:1 ratio is maintained. Is it clear? Yes, 4:1 ratio is maintained, hence it is a homogeneous mixture. That homogeneous mixture is known as solution. Now here also vaporization occurs. Suppose under normal conditions, how many molecules we are expecting? Some 5 molecules in the vapor state we are expecting. These are the molecules we are expecting. But these of all are coming from where? From upper surface. Whereas upper surface molecules are eligible. Upper surface molecules are having stamina and the strength to enter into the vapor state. But here, in this case, all upper molecules, 5 out of 5 are having ability to enter into the vapor state. That's what vapor molecules are of this much number, and corresponding pressure is also high. And that is vapor pressure of pure solvent. But in this case, out of 5, one is unfit because it is solute molecule. That solute molecule is having solid in physical state. To convert towards the liquid state, to convert towards the higher kinetic energy containing liquid, it takes lot of energy. So under this particular situation, that solid material generally outside it maintains as solid physical state. Hence, it is not at all liquid implies, its corresponding vaporization requires more amount of energy, thus vaporization is not possible for that. So therefore, see, let us consider out of these 5 out of 5 are providing, but this is unfit implies, I am considering that this particular molecule is not present in the vapor state, that is absent. If it is solvent, then this is also fit, the corresponding molecule is also fit, that situation is here. This is solvent related situation, that is major component related situation, and this is solution related situation, and corresponding solution related vapor pressure is present like this. Now if I observe, if I measure the pressure, yes, this pressure I am measuring here, here also I am measuring the pressure. This pressure is pure solvent related pressure, generally indicated by P0. 0 stands for what? 0 contamination, there is nothing. Nothing is added, only pure compound is taken. Under that conditions, whichever pressure is there, that is said to be vapor pressure of solvent, and that is indicated by technically with a letter, that is what? P0. And here this is vapor pressure of solution, hence it is normally indicated by what? PS. S stands for what? Solution, a homogeneous mixture. By observing these particular things within the same volume, 5 molecules are present which are responsible for the vapor pressure. But whereas within the same volume of that particular container, 4 molecules are present, hence vapor pressure will be little. Vapor pressure depends on what? Number of molecules. From ideal gas equation, PV is equal to what? nRT. Here all things are remains constant. Temperature remains constant, volume remains constant, gas constant is constant. Pressure, one of the pressure is vapor pressure. Pressure depends on what? Number of molecules. Here more number of molecules are there, hence more will be the vapor pressure. Here lesser number of molecules are present in vapor state, hence the corresponding vapor pressure is also little. Thus, by looking at this, we can say that P0 is always greater than compared to PS because it is non-volatile solute is present. What is present here? Solute is present. That solute is which one? Solid. Solute is, solid implies what? This is non-volatile. Non-volatile implies what? It is not easily convertible to the vapor state. Due to that reason, the total vapor pressure of solution is always less compared to the vapor pressure of pure solvent. Now, with respect to the solution, if we study how mathematically these two things are related with one another, let us have a calculation. See, here this is solution molecule, solution system. In the solution system, these molecules are of solute molecules and remaining all molecules are solvent molecules. If I take total solution, otherwise a particular layer of solution, it becomes same because ratio remains same. Here, for the vapor pressure of pure solvent P0, P0 is proportional to, here I am considering these molecules are of solute molecules NB and these molecules are of what? NA, solvent molecules. So therefore, with respect to the solution, if I take solution as reference, from solution I am visualizing solvent. Yes, if this is solution, corresponding vapor pressure is present. Suppose if it is present in the form of solvent, NA molecules and NB molecules present in each layer are responsible for the highest pressure, and that highest pressure is P0, hence P0 is proportional to what? Number of molecules of solvent plus number of molecules of solute. Whereas the exact pressure of solution is little because here the number of vapor molecules are little, because only solvent molecules, capacity containing molecules, energy containing molecules, strength containing molecules, higher kinetic energy containing molecules are entered into vapor state. So therefore, here PS, that is vapor pressure of solution, is proportional to number of molecules of A present in total or present in any layer. So therefore, this is proportional, this is also proportional. Both will maintain same proportionality constant because both relates to the same system and both are discussing about a particular criteria. In both cases, that criteria is same. So if I take a ratio mathematically, that is P0, PS divided by P0, if I take, that will becomes equal to proportionality in both the cases is getting cancelled. That will becomes equal to what? NA divided by NA plus NB. Whereas from mole fraction of the last classes and the last session's discussion, it is clear that number of molecules of component divided by total number of molecules of the component, total number of moles of the component, that will nothing but what? Mole fraction of component, that is mole fraction of A. A stands for what here? A is major component and that is known as what? Solvent. Whereas B, generally we will say A and B, B is minor component and that is known as what? Solute over here. So therefore, PS by P0 will become equal to what? Mole fraction of solvent, and here mathematically it also becomes equal to what? P0 into XA. So therefore, the vapor pressure of solution can be expressed in terms of vapor pressure of solvent and in terms of mole fractions also. So therefore, PS, automatically PS will becomes equal to P0 into XA, that is vapor pressure of solution. This PS here, vapor pressure of solution will becomes equal to vapor pressure of solvent multiple times of into mole fraction of solvent. So therefore vapor pressure of solution will becomes equal to vapor pressure of solvent into mole fraction of solvent, because solvent is having higher vapor pressure. In that higher vapor pressure, some fractional value we are taking. So therefore, compare it to the vapor pressure of the solvent, vapor pressure of solution is always little, and that will be given by Ps equal to P0 into xA. Ps is equal to what? P0 into xA. This is also known as Raoult's law. Similarly, we can also extend this one from the mole fractions related information, that Ps is equal to P0 into xA can be written as 1 minus xB, because it is a binary composition. So therefore, it will becomes equal to P0 minus P0 into xB. So therefore, if I rearrange the things, that is P0 into xB will becomes equal to P0 minus Ps. That implies P0 minus Ps by P0 will becomes equal to what? xB. This is relative lowering in vapor pressure, difference in vapor pressures of solvent to the solution, which is known as lowering in vapor pressure. That lowering in vapor pressure with respect to the total vapor pressure of the solvent, original vapor pressure of the solvent, pure vapor pressure of the solvent is said to be lowering by total, is said to be relative lowering in vapor pressure. That relative lowering in vapor pressure will becomes equal to mole fraction of what is B here, solute. Mole fraction of solute will becomes equal to relative lowering in vapor pressure, whereas vapor pressure of solution will becomes equal to multiplication product of vapor pressure of solvent multiple times of mole fraction of the solvent. So the definition can be stated about the validity of the relation, which is known as Raoult's law. Raoult's law says that Ps is equal to P0 into xA, that is the vapor pressure of a solid in liquid solution is equal to the multiplication product of vapor pressure of the pure solvent and its mole fraction, that is Ps of a solid in liquid solution's vapor pressure, which is equal to P0 vapor pressure of the pure solvent into mole fraction of the solvent. Similarly, on advancing the mathematical formula, relative lowering in vapor pressure, that is P0 minus Ps by P0, this is lowering in vapor pressure, difference in vapor pressures of solvent and the solution, that is said to be lowering in vapor pressure. Lowering in vapor pressure with respect to the vapor pressure of the solvent, which is known as relative lowering in vapor pressure, that relative lowering in vapor pressure will becomes equal to mole fraction of what? Solute. And this is mole fraction of solvent multiple times of what? Solvent. That is known as vapor pressure of solution, and this is known as relative lowering in vapor pressure. Whereas this relative lowering in vapor pressure, once again in modified version, it can be written as, see here, P0 minus Ps by P0, which will becomes equal to what? xB. xB can be given by NB divided by NA plus NB. But in general, what happens? NB is very, very small, because it is very dilute solutions. So as being it is dilute solutions, if I neglect the NB present in the denominator, then it will becomes equal to what? NB by NA. Approximately it will becomes equal to NB by NA, and that NB by NB, NA can be written as weight B by gram molecular weight of B, and here weight A, this is gram molecular weight of A. Like this, you can calculate the relative lowering in vapor pressure, and relative lowering in vapor pressure is approximately becomes equal to what? NB by NA, and that is also becomes equal to what? Weight B. B implies what? Solute. Gram weight of solute by gram molecular weight of solute into gram molecular weight of solvent divided by weight of A. These are the relations generally used for the calculations of vapor pressure of solution, lowering in vapor pressure, relative lowering in vapor pressure, similarly number of moles of solvent, number of moles of solute, and weight of solvent, weight of solute, gram molecular weight of solvent, and the gram molecular weight of solute. In this way, many varieties of numericals are covered, can be covered with this logical relation. Let us go for one problem to make this one very clear, that how many things can be asked over this particular formula. See, now we are going for a problem which will covers the rounds. There is some water solvent, water of 90 ml is present. In this 90 ml water, the corresponding vapor pressure of water is found to be 400 mmHg under given conditions of temperature. Whereas in that water of 90 ml water, whereas density of water is found to be 190 ml implies what? That is 90 grams. In that 90 ml water, 1 mole of a non-electrolyte is added. As a result, it becomes a homogeneous mixture. Homogeneous mixture is formed, uniform density containing mixture is formed, and that is said to be homogeneous mixture, that is solution formation occurred. Now what will be the vapor pressure of the solvent? That is nothing but what? Vapor pressure 400 mmHg is P0. Then you are asked to calculate what is vapor pressure of the solution. Vapor pressure of solvent is given as 400 mmHg, and the mole fractions you can calculate from here. Now you are asked to calculate vapor pressure of what? Solution. Now from the Raoult's law, we know the relation that vapor pressure of solvent PS will becomes equal to what? P0 into what? XA. That is vapor pressure of solution. Vapor pressure of solution. This is vapor pressure of solvent. And this is vapor pressure of major component. That is mole fraction of major component. Mole fraction of solvent. That is major component. Now from this relation we can calculate the vapor pressure of the solution. That is, always you remember that before P0 PS is smaller, because PS is a fraction of the P0, because mole fraction is always a proper fraction which is less than one quantity. So therefore PS will becomes equal to P0 into mole fraction XA can be given by what? Na divided by Na plus Nb, number of moles of solvent divided by total number of moles of solvent plus solute will becomes equal to what? Its mole fraction. And as for the given information, Na is how much here? That is number of moles of water will be given by 90 grams of water. So therefore mole fraction of A will becomes equal to Na. Na can be given by weight upon gram molecular weight divided by Na plus Nb, once again weight upon gram molecular weight, plus Nb. Nb can be given by what? 1 mole. So therefore that will be 5 divided by 5 plus 1 will becomes equal to what? 5 by 6. So therefore PS will becomes equal to P0. P0 is 400 into 5 by 6. So this will becomes equal to 36. 36 implies 4. 36. So therefore this is 33. So therefore this will becomes equal to how much? 333 mm of Hg. So therefore here in a water of 90 ml, after adding 1 mole of electrolyte, whichever is having vapor pressure of 400 mmHg in the beginning, now it is reduced to some new value. That new value is lesser than 400, and it is found to be how much here? 333 mm of Hg of the vapor pressure is present for the solution, because the mole fraction of the solvent is 5 by 6. That is 5 by 6 times of vapor pressure is present for the solution.